Hey, what's going on, everybody? All right, I got a really cool workflow for you guys this time. As you can see here, SpotterBot 2099 in the house. Actually, I tried to keep this simple, but I got carried away like I always do. Literally, I just started with this, y'all. Where is it? Come on. Oh my Lord. Yeah, see, you can definitely tell I got carried away. Anyways, I was trying to just make a shield of some sort, and yeah, here it is. And I just that like that's what I was gonna show, literally that. And then that happened. So, but anyways, let me get into it. So this is involving what I showed before with the array mesh stuff. If you didn't see it, check those videos out. You'll see how you can get dual symmetry, like local symmetry on one thing and also across the x-axis at the same time, or a radial array around the world center. So what this is the radial array. The legs are something different. I'm not going to go into it in this video. It's an array mesh, but it's a chain stage of array mesh that chains one piece in a loop, and then I just did the radial with that. But anyways, okay, so what we're gonna do for this workflow is come down to cylinder center, okay? Oh, that's not the one I want. That was just one that I had messed around with. And those are the bullets, and this is the legs. So what we want is, actually, I'll just backspace this one because I didn't like this piece at all. Let's go all the way back. Okay, so what this is involving is, and I love comboing things in ZBrush. That's what makes it such a great program. Like, there's 10 different ways to do everything, it seems like, but that allows for a lot of freedom and creative ways to do different workflows. So that's what I want to show is stager with array mesh with thick skin to get kind of to maintain the hard surface look. So what we're gonna do is take this thing and stage it. So we have it at the world center right now. So let's say I want to add another piece to this crazy thing. I don't really, but I'm gonna have to. So let's do like a well, we don't want to cap those. I guess I'll just do like a little barrel of some sort that will go, on top of the bottom guns or something. So what we're gonna do is a Potter's wheel method, and that is radial symmetry. So I'm gonna, since this is world center, what I'm gonna do first is actually let's kill this stage. This is something cool with stager, guys. So on something that I already have staged, not that one that you want this to fit on. Let me just click on it. Let me go out of solo mode. So let's put this on the little ones, the little guns. And it's gonna be like a little barrel coming out of them. So to get it right in position, what I want to do is get this right over top of the one. So this is already staged. This little barrel is, it's already, you'll see if I switch stage, it's moving all those in because it's an array as well. So if I turn array off, you'll see all that is one piece in the middle. I've staged it and then I arrayed it. So what I can do is come to geometry, stager, copy this, okay, because its home stage is let's see what happened there. Yeah. It doesn't matter what position it's in. I'm gonna copy it though. Because it's gonna pull its home and target. And since its home is world center, just like this one is, and I named these claws for whatever reason. I meant to name these claws. Let me just fix that real fast. All right. Go back to this. Now what you can do is where I copied that stage under geometry and stager here, you can paste. And now when I switch stage, you're gonna see that one goes right down and actually stretches a little because that's what that other one did, and that's fine. Ideally, you wouldn't want it to stretch, so you would just, reset the target stage and do it manually and line it up. But this just makes it so much faster, and it makes it fit perfect anyway. So we're still gonna work on it in the World Center, but now you'll notice when I hit array, well, you can't really see it yet. So let's kind of fix this first. So let's bring it back. Actually, we don't even have to go back. We can just switch stage. All right, so this is the Potter's Wheel method, and what I'm going to do is kind of just hit thick skin, guys, because you'll see if I don't hit thick skin, clay buildup is going to really, like, you gotta have to really light touch with, especially at radial count of 82. So I'm going to activate thick skin while it's in this form, and what that will allow me to do is kind of, it just limits the sculpting, and I love this with the radial because you can get some awesome, stuff like that, and then just smooth out. It's Dynamesh, it's gonna be messy. Like, you can clean it up after, it's all good. So let's just give it like a little, like a point or something, like kind of angle it down. Flare it a little bit right there. It's so easy. Like, it makes it so easy. Thick skin makes this thoughtless, and it's really fun. And then you can crank your radial down, if you want, and then like you do some stuff like this if you want, or even whatever looks cool to you. That doesn't look great. Let's see what this does. Let's go down a little bit more in the count, and whatever happens here, I'm just gonna okay, I know what to do. Let's go. Well, I'm not sure that looks awesome either, but whatever, you get the point. I'm just gonna go straight back. All right. Anyways, actually, I'm just gonna, that didn't look good at all. So, but you get the point. You can, thick skin's gonna limit it, so whatever you wanna do, feel free to press as hard as you want. And another cool thing about thick skin is if you turn it back to zero and go over this, it's gonna go right back to normal. Okay, so it's like a non-destructive workflow. The only time you're locked in is when you unclick thick skin, then you would have to go back because now, this is, the thick skin is there, like you're not gonna get rid of it. Anyways, now I can switch stage, and this is gonna keep that and put it down there, which it's still kind of hard to see because that thing is overlapping it. So let's just recenter this and let's turn radial off. I'm just gonna kind of move it out like that. And now I'm going to turn, so let's shrink it down a bit. So it's like a nozzle coming out of the bullet hole or something like that. Make it a different color. And now I'll add the array to it. And bam, it's right in place. And that's what I wanted to show you guys because now all you have to do is duplicate that off. And now you have something that literally is done and staged and arrayed in the proper place. And now you can just step back with, like, I duplicated this subtool, right? Okay. So now I'm going to go back to my old one and step back to where I was here, and now I have my stage set, my array set, and all I got to do is sculpt a different design or tweak it. And if I want to stage it in a different area, that's totally fine. I can do that too. I can kill these stages and set it in a different area. This whole thing was done very quickly in Array Mesh. Like, I just pulled parts together and used the same stage in the same array. I didn't use thick skin for all of it. I just wanted to show that that's really useful with the radial method. And the radial method, how useful it is for hards, like round, like gun barrels and stuff. And that's pretty much it for this one, guys. I just wanted to really showcase something a little more than a plane, like I said, or, you know, like I did in the other videos. So, also, before I peace out, I wanted to mention that you guys should totally check out, because I made this with Array Mesh as well. This is probably the last one I'll do on Array Mesh for a while. But this is something that I didn't even know how to do, but it's literally one pedal. And you should check this guy's channel out, because I found the tutorial there. I'm going to put the link in the description. Seems like a cool guy. I talked to him. Asked him if I could link it there. And I followed the tutorial and I made a flower. The only thing I did different was I used a little bit of fiber mesh and used convert BPR to geo to use it for something other than fiber mesh, like whatever, the things on a flower that come out of the middle, up pistols or stamens or whatever they're called. I don't even remember. But all I did, you know, you can see this is the original array. He uses a little trick to pull something out and to offset the pivot. It's pretty cool. So definitely check that out, guys. So I just wanted to show that. And then the only other thing, actually, I think, yeah, this real quick. Right here, I wanted to make a banana clip. Like minigun thing. That was a Ray Mesh too. I thought I might use this one, but I like the SpiderBot better. So, but I just kind of wanted to, like, there's so much you can do with this. All right, that's everything. So thanks, guys. See you next time.